Wanting to be an astronaut as a kid is like a rite of passage. We've all been there, right? As a kid, it's easy to see those videos of adults just floating around in space and wanting so badly to be one of them. But there's a lot of things about living in space that aren't as commonly talked about, some of which might make you change your mind or make you want to be an astronaut even more, depending on where you draw the line between fascinating and freaky. Astronauts make a lot of sacrifices when they venture off of Earth. 16 times a day, 7 people whiz by above your head in a football field-sized home of metal and solar panels. And while you're looking up at them, they're looking down at you. Though some of the things that happen in space might be funky, I have no doubt that living on the International Space Station is also a lot of fun. Why else would there be so many astronauts lining up to do it? Some everyday things are near impossible for astronauts to do in space. Here are some of the most surprising facts about living in space. The water supply is limited on the ISS, which forces astronauts to get creative in keeping their H2O supply stocked. In conditions of almost non-existent gravity, everything flies freely in space. Liquids fly around and scatter all over the spacecraft. To avoid this, all liquid food is absorbed and consumed in special packages. To stay hydrated, astronauts in space capture their wastewater, which can be urine, sweat, or even just the moisture from their breath. Then use the closed loop system they have on board to filter out any impurities or contaminants from the water. Once it's run through the filter, the water can be used for drinking, bathing, rehydrating food, etc. So a cup of coffee or water can be made from the previous day's waste. This might sound a little yucky, but NASA says the recycled water on the ISS is actually cleaner than what most Earthlings drink. Have you ever wondered what it's like to eat like an astronaut living and working in space? These days, there are about 200 different food and beverage options that are sent up with astronauts as part of the standard menu. They have several different kinds of commercial cereals that they package with non-fat dried milk, and they add water on orbit, and that's how they get their cereal and milk. Sure, many of them are dried and may not exactly be the snacks we crave down on Earth, but still, there are plenty of food items to choose from. You are allowed 3 meals a day. 200 miles above Earth, gravity is extremely low. To prevent anything from floating away, utensils are secured to magnets on food trays. Food is also securely packaged to prevent food from floating around the station. Another reason for careful packing is to avoid any crumbs. NASA officials said liquids and crumbs could damage equipment on the ISS. The transportation cost for a pound of food is about $10,000. Astronauts in need of a caffeine fix are in luck, because they can have coffee. They just have to tell us if they want it with sugar or creamer. Coffee in space comes in a silver pouch and is drank with a straw. Astronauts do celebrate the holidays with special meals. Those meals just come in pouches instead of on plates. If an astronaut wants some extra seasonings, salt and pepper come in liquid form, according to NASA. The US military does make some shelf-stable bread products that they buy and use, and one of those is called the Maple Top Muffin. That's one of the items that a lot of crew members select for breakfast as well. Since there's no toast in space, astronauts make do with what's available, flour tortillas. Some even made a peanut butter and honey sandwich on a flour tortilla. Though serving up a savory breakfast on a tortilla is quite common too. A lot of them do make breakfast tacos. They'll take the flour tortilla and put the freeze-dried egg, and maybe cut up the sausage patty and put it in there. They do have a squeezed cheese product, like a cheese spread. Each crew member gets to bring on some personal goodies for further customization of their meals. When they're on orbit, on station for 6 months, they get 9 containers that we call crew-specific menu containers. So those 9 containers will have their name on them, and they will get to decide what goes in there. That each of the international partners involved in the ISS sends their astronauts up with their own food supplies, which can consist of dehydrated snacks and other thermostabilized and packaged food items that they can all share with each other. And really, that monotony is the hardest part about space food, because when it's all said and done, eat dried foods in space is kind of boring. It's just scrambled eggs, cereal with milk, and other normal dishes you'd find here on Earth. But hey, at least the view is nice, since there is no gravity. On the space station, water particles fly in the air and can be scattered everywhere. Therefore, you will clean your hands by pouring soap that does not require rinsing onto a towel. To take a shower, you should apply the same method to your whole body. After brushing your teeth, you have to swallow the liquid in your mouth. How to use the toilet on the space station. They float into the WHC and they have toilet, which consists of a seat and metal bucket. Depending on how many people are there, it holds about maybe 30 deposits. The urine goes into this hose right here, and this valve is what activates the whole system. The feces that come out of your body can also fly in the air. That's why you should tie your legs with a belt to secure yourself after sitting on the special vacuum toilet seat. The vacuum hoses will collect all the waste in the tank. All right, now we're on the inside of the hygiene compartment. Close the door so that you have your privacy. You take the funnel. It's very, very convenient because it's just one valve operates it all. When cutting hair and beards, shavers with hoses should be used so that the hair does not fly in the air. For your nails, you should leave the vacuum cleaner on. They can't enjoy a hot shower. In space, water is preserved for drinking. In place of showers, astronauts take sponge baths, using water distilled from the humidity in the air, urine from oral hygiene, and hand washing, among other things. There also isn't a particularly efficient way to wash clothes, so astronauts just repeat outfits. Your 13-layer costume, which you will wear for renovations or inspections of the station's exterior, weighs 127 kilos and is worth $12 million. It will take you 45 minutes to put this suit on each time. How do they sleep in space? By the way, as an astronaut, everything you do during the day will be scheduled by those on the ground. The average time you are given for sleep is 8 hours. You sleep strapped to a wall, if you can even sleep. Like many other parts of living in space, sleeping is weird. As you likely know, there's very little gravity in space, also known as microgravity, which is the reason you see videos of astronauts and objects just floating around. It doesn't seem like it would be very restful or safe to sleep while just floating around the ESS, so astronauts sleep in sleeping bags that are strapped to the walls of their respective sleep stations. The sleep stations are phone booth CZ rooms that can also hold a computer, books, clothes, and other items to make them feel more like home. Perhaps the sleeping bag on the wall situation wouldn't bother you, however. Random flashes of light that zap through your eyes might keep you up at night, as it has some astronauts on the ISS. Those beams of light, which some astronauts have described as fireworks or streaks, are actually from cosmic rays or high energy particles that beam through the solar system, shooting through the orbiting outpost. Astronauts can't cry the same in space as they do on Earth. Your eyes make tears, but they stick as a liquid ball. In fact, they sting a bit, so space tears don't shed, unless an astronaut wipes that water away. Tears in space can form a giant clump that can break free of your eye, so in space you can actually watch a ball of your tears float around. Drinking alcohol is not allowed in space. Alcohol is not permitted on board the International Space Station for consumption, but Russian cosmonauts are apparently allowed to consume cognac for immune health. The reasoning, however, doesn't have much to do with science. Before the ban, Buzz Aldrin drank communion wine on the moon, but it was never broadcast. Sex is banned on space missions. Former and current astronauts don't like to talk about space shuttle sex. And NASA says that if it's ever happened, the agency doesn't know anything about it. It would be incredibly difficult to have sex in space, given astronauts' lack of privacy, overwhelming workloads, and lack of gravity. The panel and strap design of a space bed might not be that conducive to lovemaking. Astronauts also have a demanding work schedule, leaving them with little time or energy for messing around. What if you get sucked out of an airlock? You might think that, thanks to the unfiltered, unadulterated solar radiation, you'll be fried to a crisp in no time. In truth, it's way worse than that in the shade in space. It's like minus 250 degrees. But the part of you that's in the sun, it's plus 250 degrees at least. So it's going to start boiling and burning. So it's like lying on a red hot stove with a piece of dry ice on your back, and your lungs are going to be sucked flat instantaneously. But even worse than that is your blood is going to boil, like opening a can of pop, where suddenly all the little bubbles come out. Because there's no air pressure around you, so simultaneously, you are going to freeze, boil, burn, get the bends, and no longer be able to breathe. Not a good way to go. Living on a spaceship is the most lazy existence. You can imagine you're weightless, you do not have to lift a finger, you don't have to hold your head up, your heart doesn't have to lift your blood against gravity. In space, astronauts grow 2 inches taller because their skeletal system stretches in zero gravity. Since the fluids in your body will be evenly distributed, your nose will always be blocked and your sense of smell will atrophy over time. Many astronauts experience space sickness, which is similar to motion sickness. However, it is typically short-lived. You can be the laziest person in the universe in space, but eventually, you need to come back to Earth, and if you don't exercise for your whole 6 months in space, you'll sort of turn into a jellyfish. So they do exercise 2 hours a day on the spaceship. They have a resistive machine, they have a unicycle, and they have a treadmill where elastics hold them down just to keep their bodies strong enough and their bones dense enough. So when they get home, they don't just fall over like a puddle, but you don't need to work out all the time. So there's a lot of wood out there that if you go incredibly fast, like the speed of light, if you could travel at the speed of light, that you won't age, and despite thousands of years going by, you'll stay the same. But everybody that you know will die. That's not really true. Einstein called it relativity, because what he meant was your aging will be different relative to people's aging on Earth. You'll still age. Time will still pass for you, but people on Earth will age at a different rate, so that if you came back after going incredibly fast, you would have gotten older by the amount of time that it took for you to travel, but people on Earth would have aged much, much faster. They would have had a longer period of time, because if you get going fast enough, your speed is sort of proportional to the time passing. So you'll still age, but you just age at a different rate than people back on Earth. Einstein did this cool thought experiment. Imagine if you were looking at a clock. The light from the clock is coming and hitting your eyeballs and telling you it's 12 o'clock. Well, imagine if you could move away from that clock at the speed of light. It would only say 12 o'clock because that light, and you would be moving away from the clock at the same speed. So for you, it would look like it was always 12 o'clock forever. You'd still be getting older, but that clock would always look like it was the same time the people on Earth were continuing to live. They're not aware of you going the speed of light, so you can see that the time for you, because of your speed, is relatively different than the time for the people on Earth. It's a really unusual thing to try and grasp in your head. In the movie Interstellar, we saw that they gave a sense of time dilation. On Earth, gravity is at a reasonable rate. and the gravitational pull of the sun is normal. In real life, this process is happening all over space. An interesting example is our International Space Station. Time moves slower on the ISS compared to time on Earth. Technically speaking, it is a different time reference than ours, so we can correct the time on the ISS by calculating the difference through Einstein's equations. How many of these life in space facts did you know? Any interesting facts we missed? Share them with us in the comments. Thank you for watching. Don't forget to like this video and subscribe. We'll see you in the next video.